Blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place. Though I walk through the wilderness, blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. And when the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name.
Good evening and welcome to First Word on Wednesday, May 27th, 2020. Thank you for joining us. We've been talking about powerful words. Words like redeem and forgive and love and save and peace and last night, commit. Here's another powerful word for you. Save. Have you ever needed to be saved? I've heard this story from three different perspectives. One from my father, one from my mother, and another from my mother's best friend that I always referred to as Aunt Mary, and she was there at the occasion. And I was born, and I was not doing well. And my aunt grabbed the doctor and said, "Doctor, you cannot let this baby die." And the doctor went out in the waiting room and told my father to come into the delivery room. He said, "We need blood and we need it now." So he did a direct transfusion directly from my father to me, which saved my life. Well, God has a way of saving our lives. Save takes on a whole new meaning when we put it into the context and the will and the purpose of God. It's what He does for us spiritually, and it's what He does for us literally when He takes us from where we are and He secures our place with Him and He saves us. The story is in the 14th chapter of Matthew, and it says, "And immediately He made the disciples get into the boat and go ahead of Him to the other side, and He sent the crowds away. And after He had sent the crowds away, He went up on the mountain Himself to pray. And when it was evening, He was there alone. But the boat was already a long way away, battered by the waves, for the wind was contrary. And the fourth watch of the night, He came to them walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw Him walking on the sea, they were terrified and said, 'It is a ghost.' And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, 'Take courage. It is I. Do not be afraid.' And Peter said, 'Lord, if you command me to come to you on the water.' And He said, 'Come.' And Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came toward Jesus. But seeing the wind, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, 'Lord, save me.' And immediately Jesus stretched out His hand and took hold of him and said, 'You of little faith, why do you doubt?' And in a moment when Simon Peter was overwhelmed by the circumstance, when he could not take care of himself, when he was in a situation over which he had no control, he instinctively cried out a prayer, the prayer that many people have prayed when they've discovered that I have come to the end of my resources and there's nothing left for me to do. The prayer is, 'Lord, save me. Do for me what I cannot do for myself. Reach out to me and take me. Help me to come to you.' And Jesus was able and willing and ready, and the hand was extended, and Simon Peter was physically saved. But the spiritual side of that came also to be true. For what Simon Peter could not do for himself in the water, he could not also do for himself spiritually. As much enthusiasm as he invested in following Christ, as many times as he said the right things, As many times as he was faithful to follow Christ, he could not save himself spiritually. So one more time he cries out, "Lord, save me." The prayer of every lost person who discovers by the quickening of the Holy Spirit that God is there, God is real, God is reaching out, God is provided. And in the moment we realize that truth and we cry out to God, he is there, he is faithful, he is saving, and we give thanks for us. A powerful word, save. A powerful word that in the context of our spiritual lives belongs to God. It is one of those powerful words of love and redemption, and all those words we've talked about all rolled into one in the nature and the person of God. Let us pray. God, I thank you for the gift of saving us. I thank you for the offer to save us. I thank you for paying the price of sacrifice to spiritually save us. I thank you for reaching out to us while we are yet sinners, and yet you love us and care for us. And I pray for every person who is struggling, whatever the struggle is, every person who is ill, whatever the illness is, and every person that is searching, no matter how long the search has been or how difficult the path has been, let them find you. I pray your Spirit speak to them. And I pray they be able to pray the most simple, powerful prayer of all, "Lord, save me." God, I give thanks for your presence in the wonderful name, Jesus. Amen. And until tomorrow, even at this time, we hope that you have a blessed evening and good day tomorrow.
That were an offering far too small. My soul, my life, my